mean, that's all right. There are plenty of people, if you say, I plant my garden by the moon, they'll say, I plant mine in the ground. You know, you've heard people say that. Well, that's fine. All I'm saying is, you try this, and I will almost guarantee you that if you use otherwise every other good gardening practice, your garden will be better. It will be more productive. You'll have more flowers on your flowers. You'll have more beans on your beans if you plant them in the right size. Any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
According to the latitude of Kentucky, our Franklin area, are we considered in the northern part or the southern part?
We're in zone 6A. We are more southern than we were 5 years ago. And this is, I don't know where you are with the climate change things, but there are things that are growing that will grow in Kentucky now, southern things that would not grow here 10 or 15 years ago because the climate is warming. I mean, to me, that's scientific proof to the point where we had to be added an A in the zone because of our zone is warmer than what it was just a few years ago. Yeah, we're south.
I saw an article, and I think it was in something like the AARP magazine or whatever. And actually, it was about warming in that our average temperature over a year's time is 60 degrees now. And it used to be 55 degrees, something like that, and now it's gone up that much.
Well, I think probably all of us here, but Josh can remember one, and he's from Bowling Green, which is a little further south. But can remember when we were growing up how much snow there was from like Thanksgiving all the way to spring. It wasn't like there was one big snowstorm in January and then it was gone in 3 weeks. At least for those of you that grew up in central Kentucky and I grew up in Lexington, I know there was snow all the time. May not have been a lot, but there was snow all now. It's fits and spurs.
I moved to Frankfort in the fall of 61. Son was friends and skated with them out here. They call Black's Pond, and it's now they call Silver Lake. They ice skated every winter on that fall till he was grown, and then they would slate. But
now
the ice skating did not break through.
Now you'd be afraid.
And it was deeper than it is now. Now it never. I live out there. I don't think you ever see much ice on it when you do. It's just thin.
Maybe the winter of 78, it might have frozen. Pardon me. I think that was. Yes, ma'am.
When you say the waxing and the waning, on this sheet right here under the moon's phases, Eastern Daylight Time, the first quarter and the last quarter, that would be either the waning or the waxing, correct?
The first quarter and the second quarter, there where it says new moon, this June's an easy one because the new moon came in on the first. Mm-hmm. So through the first quarter, it's waxing, it's growing. Through the second quarter, it's growing.
Okay.
It's growing, waxing. Then on the full moon, which is on the 15th, mm-hmm. then it starts waning there, and it's waning there. It's waning into the last quarter, and until next Friday, it will continue to be waning. Then we'll be back to the new moon, which is no moon visible. This is not an easy thing to grasp in 30 minutes or whatever we've talked. But all I know, as I've said before, is I know it works.
How do you know which day November is?
They're in the almanac. There ought to be some over there. Let's see here. We hit them the third week, the week of the 20th, the week that says 24th Pentecost Sunday. Starting the week of the 12th. There are three. Every time they occur, there are three. They're on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday.
And what are they?
Well, they're just super killing days. And if you Google that.
Well, now what I'm looking at is Wednesday the 15th.
Wednesday the 14th. Well, Wednesday
then
the 15th.
Friday and Saturday.
See, it says Ember Day on the 15th. Mm-hmm. Then Friday and Saturday are both Ember Days.
Right. See, I tried to find it on the. My almanac didn't say anything about Ember Day. That I printed off the computer, so then I got in there and just keyed in Ember Days. And it had to do with religious.
Right, it's a certain period after Easter.
Yeah.
And hit on a bad time in June, because as I recall, those were pretty good days in June. Well, it was a Capricorn day, Capricorn on the 17th and 18th, and on the 15th, it was Sagittarius. It was the middle, but in the middle of a so-so time. They're just a super killing day. There's a story in the Foxfire book about somebody that on a particular day in May, on a killing day. Now, if you were to hit like Aries or Leo on an Ember day, oh, I wouldn't even get out of bed. But they claim that they drove a nail into a tree. This is a story in the Foxfire book. I cannot testify to the veracity of it. They drove a nail into a large tree to kill the tree. It's that kind of killing day. I try to avoid them. I mean, obviously, you got to go on with life, but you don't have a plan.
Now, the Ember days, are they based on the moon, too, or are they the same every June the 17th?
No, it's based on when Easter is, and Easter has that formula, which I can't ever remember, but the formula that it rotates where I
so Easter. So every year, Ember Day will be a different day.
Like this year, Easter was as late as it can be. I think it can be one day later. And then in 2010, it was in the middle of March, and it's about as early as it can be. So it's something with the way that the calendar falls. And these Ember days will be on prescribed days after that.
So Ember days are the shining killing days?
Yes, ma'am. You want something killed, kill it on Ember Day.
When's the next Ember Day?
I don't know. We're done for this. We may be done for the summer. I hope so. Because all too often they fall on a planting day. And just real reluctant to plant on those days. Other questions? Observations?
Ember day is Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday.
No, they're Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday.
Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday.
They break the same
line. Just on this month.
Yeah.
Thursday, for some reason, isn't it? It's 3 days in the same week, but Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday.
But next year, it'd be totally different.
It'd be Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. It could be different. The numbers will likely be different. It will be on different days, dates. But the days will be Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday.
Okay.
Always. Throughout this year. Mm-hmm.
Always. The dates will be different. It may not be June. It may not be next year because Easter's a different day. It may be in the previous
week. So you only have three Ember days the whole year?
No. They're about 3 months that have Ember days, but they're separated by several months. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, all we have here is just June. Well, I have it here, but I realize I've talked too long now.
Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday.
But I'll be happy to answer any questions. I think I've about hit the high points of it. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to make a comment that for people who think that the earth is not affected by the moon, they need to observe the tides.
Yes.
They need to observe the wildlife in the ocean, how they come up at certain times in the moon to lay their eggs on the beach. And the babies in the hospital, which are working. They usually are born at the end of the full moon. And so the moon has a wonderful effect on the earth. And so that's why I don't understand why people make fun of this.
And one of the aspects that you brought up there is the time of the month when we can, what I call making changes. And I have that in my column every month. Is when the moon is going is in the dark phase, and the signs are going out of the body past anything that functions. Now, functions is like your stomach or your heart or your lungs. When it gets to the legs, I mean, obviously your legs are important, but they don't have a function like our internal organs do. Now, we've had, in the last 2 months, we've had real long stretches of that, and I'll show you where it is here on the calendar this month. If you look at June, the 14th, That's where Sagittarius starts. Well, you see, the moon did not change phases until late on the 15th. So that meant Sagittarius that day was in the light moon. Most of the next day was in the light moon. But then beginning on the 16th, we were in the dark moon, and the sign was in Sagittarius, which is the thighs. The sign was going out of the body past anything that functioned. So then we went down and we had 2 days of Capricorn, that's the knees. Then we had 3 days of Aquarius, which is the lower legs. And then we had 2 days of the feet, which is Pisces, which was through yesterday. So we in effect had from the 16th through the 23rd to make changes. Now this I have a lot of people call and say, when is that time going to be? Because it's usually either I want to wean my cattle, my calves, or my colts, or my children, or I want to stop smoking, I want to start a diet, I want to start an exercise program. And for some reason, Sally, that's what you're saying, that the moon affects positively during that period of time. If I were going to have elective surgery, now that's not like if I dropped dead of a heart attack and I tell Josh to wait to take me to the hospital until the next signs are right, you know, you will have come to my funeral before then. Elective surgery, something that you need to have done, but it's not an emergency. I would schedule that surgery during that period of time.
Got the concept.
Is it when the
signs are leaving the body?
Right. When the signs, you see with these, signs up here on a little chart. Different ones rule different parts of the body. Now they rule different parts of the body. And each of us, whatever month we were born in, we have our birth month. Whatever that sign, if you were born under any of these 12 zodiac signs, and we all were. A lot of times, more often than not, I found people tend to reflect the characteristics of people born, what they say. For instance, as I said, I'm a Gemini. Geminis typically, I hate to say with multiple personalities because that sounds like some kind of a psychiatric disorder, but we typically do. A lot of times, Geminis do two things. They have two careers. I've had two careers all my life. Many of you know I'm an ordained minister, which a lot of people can't see how in the world that jives with talking about zodiac signs. But I don't have any problem with that at all. But I have done that in journalism all my adult life. Since 1969, I've done both of those things at the same time. All right, so these things, they affect us. And they rule these parts of the body. Now here we go. We're going to go one more time on it, okay? We're going to do it together. The signs are going out of the body past anything that functions. Functions meaning heart, lungs, any part of, you know, what functions, what doesn't, bowels, whatever. When it's something that doesn't function, like my leg, I can lay it up here, but I don't have anything in there that it's chopped off. I may bleed to death, but I'm not going to, my heart's not going to stop unless somebody doesn't get the bleeding stopped. That's Sagittarius. The next one is Capricorn. That's the knee. The next one is Aquarius. Remember the dawning of the age of Aquarius? We all enough to remember that. Josh isn't, but some of us are. I'm sorry about that.
Poor Josh. That's a lot.
And then finally, Pisces, the feet. Now it occurs that in planning, these three signs are the so-so signs. Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius are the three so-so signs. Pisces happens to be a fertile sign. That's got nothing in the world to do with this idea of this beyond things that function and making changes. Now, the way the moon's going to rotate over the next few months, by the time we get to about November, December, there may be one day in a month that this formula will fit.